Hey friends, welcome to Future. In today's episode, we are gonna learn how you can create scannable and beautiful versions of your QR code within a very few minutes. First, you need your QR code. Let's go to this website. Select your code action. I'll set it to browse to our website. Code type QR code, website URL. I'll be using this URL here. For URL shortening, if you have a very long URL, then you should definitely use this one because the less data you put in that QR code, the more scannable it will be. Error correction level, always high. Margin sizes blocks, let's set it to 3 and generate code. Here now we have our code. Let's jump into Stable Diffusion. We are gonna use Rave Animated model for this tutorial. Drop your image here. For this one, that will be this QR code. Sampling method, DPM plus 2M Keras. Well, this is good for most of the cases, that's why we are using this one. Sampling steps 20. Let's start with denoising strength of 100%. In most tutorials I have seen they are using just one control net unit, but we are gonna use two. That's because you cannot really control them the way you want with just one unit. We'll be using one unit for the image and another unit for the QR code. That's why it increases both the beauty of the image as well as the scannability. Let's drop your image here, which should be the QR code. Enable it, set it to pixel perfect, preprocessor. Now this is another thing most people have a misconception about. In most of the tutorials I have seen they are using InPaint Global Harmonious Preprocessor. Well, preprocessor processes the images in a certain way that makes the control net generate the images in certain way. If we are applying this preprocessor, it's the same image. There is nothing different here. And if we set it to none, it's also the same image. The first model should be control net type. The control weight should be 1. Let's set the control step from a range of somewhere around 35% to 60%. Let's write a beautiful prompt. Set the batch count to somewhere around 6 to 8 and hit generate. The results are really beautiful here, but they are not really scannable, making them just useless. Now let's add scannability to that. We're gonna keep everything, the seed, the prompt, all the same. Now I'm gonna add another control net unit. Enable this, set it to pixel perfect, preprocessor again none. This time the model should be the control net brightness model. I'll lower the control weight in this one somewhere around 34%, 35%. If it works, then okay. If not, then we'll increase the control weight from there. Starting and ending control step in this case would be 0 to 100. We want it to be applied all along the generation. Let's hit generate again. Now we have the same images, but these are a lot more scannable, but not as beautiful as we wanted it to be, right? Let's change up things a little bit again. We're going to the tile control net unit, setting the starting control step to a little bit higher, somewhere around 45%, and hit generate again. The images are a lot more beautiful right now, and this time they are not just beautiful. Among 8 of them, 7 are scannable. That is most of them. If you want one magic setting that works right away and solves all your problems and can work in any and every situation, then I'm sorry to burst your bubble, because such setting does not exist. Yeah, I keep saying lots and lots of online tutorials. They are giving us settings away and saying this is the only settings that you need. But it doesn't work that way. Your prompts, sampling methods, models that you are using, everything changes the resulting image in some way. So you have to learn how you can fine tune them so you can make it work in any and every situation. If you want more scannability to the QR code, you increase the model weight at brightness unit, or you decrease the starting step at the tile unit. If you want less scannability but more beautiful images, you decrease the model weight at brightness unit and increase the starting step at tile unit. Now the tutorial seems to end here, but you can't really find that image that you saw on the thumbnail, right? Well, I have added one more magic trick to that. Let's keep this one just the same, but add two more LoRa models. I have put the link in the description for those LoRa models. You just have to go there, download the files, open them to the folder Stable Diffusion WebUI Models LoRa and restart the WebUI. Let's click on this button here, go to LoRa. Here we can find this kids illustration and detail enhancer LoRa. I have clicked on them, they are already added in the prompt. Now let's generate again. And there's a good news for you all. I shall be choosing 15 people at random and making such beautiful QR codes from them for their preferred URLs and send them via mail. you can just go to pixsensation.substack.com, subscribe to our AI newsletter there, and drop an email from that same email ID to contact@pixsensation.com. You must mention has QR code challenge as well as your preferred URL in the mail. I'll be sure to get back to you as soon as possible. Now, as you can see, our images are generated and those are much more beautiful compared to before. Now, most results generated by this method might not be scannable, but those that are scannable, those are very beautiful and very much usable. If you want to learn more in depth about this topic, then you should definitely check out this video right here.